Welcome to podcast number 5. This podcast is specifically about the film Leave the World Behind, and I'm hoping that people might see this before they watch the film. I watched it with my wife, and within seconds we could see red flags everywhere. It's subliminal messaging gone mad, and it starts at the beginning with the executive producers. It's the Obamas. And just a quick reminder of exactly who these two are. A lot of people just remember him as the former president of America and the former first lady, but that's not what they're about. Anyway, over to the film.
This morning, and I rented us a beautiful house out by the beach. I figured if I made the reservation and packed our bags, it would eliminate most of the reasons to say no.
Oh, this is nice. Kids look so happy.
The Wi-Fi isn't working. Get a pad.
I'm so sorry to bother you, but this is our house.
This is your house?
We were driving back to the city, then something happened.
You want to stay here, but we're staying here.
We need to get them out of here.
I need to think everything's gonna be okay.
Everything is gonna be okay, isn't it?
We are seeing ongoing cyber attacks across the country.
Something is happening, and I don't trust them.
Everything I know, I have told you.
I don't believe you.
I would do anything to protect my family. What you do is your business.
Get in the car right now!
Haven't you been picking up on what's going on out there?
Whatever it is, it's happening to all of us.
No, no, no. I just want to know, what is the truth?
Now it's all about the ship. Keep an eye on the ship. Red, black, and white lion. Still not quite sure what the white lion represents, but I'm looking into it. This is another bit that I thought was strange. This reminded me of the story of Mary and Joseph and the innkeeper, Bethlehem and what have you. The black guy, very, very humble. And he remains humble throughout the film. This is one of the first introductions to sort of desexualising young teenagers half naked with tattoos. It's uncomfortable to watch, actually, this part, even though I appreciate she's over 18, it is still uncomfortable. Here again, we've got NASA. Why she's wearing a NASA t-shirt, I don't know. But more importantly, watch his change to this Obey t-shirt, red and black, featuring Biggie Smalls. For those of you who don't remember who Biggie Smalls was, check out what happened to him and check out the date that it happened. Remembering that the Cabal, the Elite, are very, very into numbers 369, for example. What you're going to see coming up now is 5G being activated for the very first time. And what happens next is pretty horrific. And it shows you whether it's crowd control or whatever you want to use it for. You can stop people dead in their tracks.
Where are my kids?
Thank you.
see the red pamphlets there being scattered by drones. Again, red propaganda. This is really pushing that any trouble that's coming is coming from the east. And then the next dig you'll see, which isn't subtle at all, is really aimed at Tesla, Elon Musk, and the automated car. And I wonder whether or not this is because of the things he says, or is this just indirectly adverse sort of branding and marketing?
Whoa, hey, someone's coming. Yo!
And now a weird conversation using a story from the Bible.
Anyway, the story was about a man who lived by the river. And he hears on the radio that the river's going to flood the town and everyone should leave. But the man doesn't go anywhere because he prays every day, knows that God loves him and will save him. But then the flood actually happens. And this guy in a rowboat sees the man and says, "Hey, come on, I can save you." But the man tells him he isn't going anywhere. Then a helicopter comes flying by. The pilot lowers a ladder, but the man tells him he isn't going anywhere. After that, the man drowns in the flood. And so he goes up to heaven, and he's really angry at God. And he tells him, "I prayed to you every day. I thought you loved me. Why didn't you save me?" And God says, "I sent you a radio report, a rowboat, and a helicopter. What more do you want?"
What's this about, Rose?
Here again, sort of desexualizing things. This is a teenage girl in bed with her dad. And the conversation they have is about sex and racism. It is very, very odd. Shortly after this, we start to see the big emphasis around 5G and what it actually can do. And then after that, we see neighbours turn on each other. Coup d'etat, civil war. We can do the hard work for them if we fight ourselves.
I was driving around yesterday. It's a big drone dropping these everywhere. It means death to America, so we're thinking Iranians. I remember hearing something on NPR once about their cyber capabilities. Why is that funny?
Before the phones went out, I heard from a friend of mine in San Diego about a similar event, drones dropping pamphlets, except they were in Korean. Or Mandarin. Like I said, he couldn't tell which. But seeing as he did four tours in Iraq, you sure would have known if it looked like that. We made a lot of enemies around the world. Maybe all this means is a few of them teamed up.
As a master Freemason, I can assure you that this is a code.
Shit. What's going on? Before we go, I need to know that you're on a level with me.
So, I'll leave you all with one thought. Why would a former president of the United States of America finance a film about the end of the world? Answers on a postcard, please. Until next time, stay free.
We need to come together and do one thing: stop participating. And when we do that, the game is over. When we literally say Monday morning, we're not going to go to work. Imagine if 30 million people didn't go to work Monday. Imagine if 30 million people didn't buy gas on Monday. Imagine if 30 million people went to the bank on Monday and said, I want to withdraw all my money. They can't even give it to all 30 million because only 15% of the cash is available on hand at any given time. The rest is fake zeros and ones. That would collapse the banking system in one day. You see the power in that? You have the power. Well, we all have the power, but what's keeping us back from doing this? Fear. Oh my God, if I don't go to work, I'm gonna get fired. And if they don't participate in it, and I'm the only one that doesn't show up for work, I'm gonna lose out, and I'm not gonna be able to pay my rent. I'm not gonna be able to make my car payment, and so forth and so on. You see the trap they have us in? They have us in this system where we're afraid to work together. Man, we're brothers, we should be, link up. Let's do this together.